Good afternoon and welcome to our memorial service. We come as individuals, as families, as friends, all aware of the grief we share, even if our circumstances and stories vary. There is no judgment here, nor any ranking of grief. It is a safe space to mourn, to cry, even to laugh, to remember and to be grateful. We hope that by being able to watch this online version of the memorial service, you will know that you are loved and held in prayer and are able in your own space to be a part of this remembrance. Please know that whatever happens, you are invited to participate as little or as much as you wish. There will be singing and you are invited to sing along or not as you feel able. The theme of our service today is that the light of Christ shines in the darkness and the darkness hasn't put it out. The challenge of these months has been to keep the darkness at bay, especially when grief adds its own shadows. In the very beginning of John's Gospel, we read these words. In the beginning, the Word already existed. The Word was with God and the Word was God. From the very beginning, the Word was with God. Through him, God made all things. Not one thing in all creation was made without him. The Word was the source of life, and this life brought light to people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has never put it out. There is no doubt that emotions are running high, and even gathering here can be very emotive for some. You may be feeling anxious or uncertain, and please be assured you are not the only one. Some of you have shared your stories or your emotions with me, and I know that as unique as these experiences are to each of us, we can empathize with one another. Everything, such as anger and disappointment, along with guilt, regret, and frustration, are felt within this space. Not only has the pandemic taken from us the opportunity to celebrate milestones in style, we were also forced to grieve in isolation. Never before have we had to limit numbers attending funerals, shorten the services, or go our separate ways after paying our final respects. Please believe me when I say that I do understand this from personal experience. And I have been through that full gamut of emotions and still I face the consequences of my choices. That said, please let me reassure as much as you can let me that you did everything you could. And I know how hard it was for many that they could not be there in the final days or hours. Please know that your loved ones knew that you loved them. And that they didn't ever think you'd stopped. I suspect almost without exception, your loved ones truly understood. It was an incredibly cruel time and presented us with challenges that we had to face and absorb when we already felt so fragile and vulnerable. At some point, if we haven't already, we will forgive ourselves. We will gather and grieve our loved ones as family and friends. We will raise a toast or plant a tree, share the stories and laugh and weep as we so dearly wanted to. So today be gentle with yourself and with one another. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from heaven will break upon us to shine on those who live in darkness under the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. I invite you, as you feel able, to sing along or simply to listen to the wonderful hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah. We're going to have a time of prayer, finishing with the Lord's Prayer, and the words will be on your screen at the end of the prayer, and please feel free to join in as you wish. Let us come before God in prayer. Let us pray. God of all comfort, in the midst of pain, heal us with your love. In the darkness of sorrow, shine upon us as the morning star. Awaken in us the spirit of mercy, that as we feel the pain of others, we may share with them the comfort we receive from you. Bring us at the last with all your people into the kingdom of your glory, where death itself is ended and every tear is wiped from every eye. As we gather to remember our loved ones, we are blessed by our memories. And we thank you for the times of contentment and joy, for the silly times and the wry smile as the stories pass through our minds. We praise you for the wee traditions we still hold on to that keep us connected to our loved ones and the past. We are grateful for the legacies we share with generations who follow when we share those stories, those traditions, and when we speak of our loved ones with love and respect. Take from us our guilt and regret, for these are millstones we cannot carry for long. We did the right thing, yet, Lord, it so often feels like the wrong thing. And there is truly no one to blame or rage against, and many of us are lost, bereft, hurting and struggling. So, Lord, we rage against you, and we beat our hands to your chest. Enfold us as we grieve, and be our comfort. May our anger, our grief, our brokenness be met by your spirit of grace, mercy, and healing. May the wounds become scars, such that we heal yet bear the marks. Give us the grace to worship you, trusting in the eternal promise that all life finds its fulfillment in you. By your power you gave us life, and in your love you are giving us new life in Jesus Christ. We have entrusted our loved ones to your safekeeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us and to bring us all to a joyful resurrection and the glory of your eternal kingdom. May we believe, however small, in the promises of your word and know your peace in our hearts, minds, and souls in this time and place. We bring all our prayers together in the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, a prayer shared around the world through all the generations, connecting us together. And so we pray. We pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Continuing our theme of light overcoming the darkness, let me share with you a few words from Psalm 139. The psalmist encourages us that there is nothing that we need to hide from God, and that there is space to be honest with God, with our negative feelings as well as our positive feelings. And when you read the Psalms, you'll know that plenty have raged with God. God loves you, and your loved one was also known, loved, and held by God. I genuinely believe that we do not cross the last divide by ourselves. Indeed, angels surround us, and God is present with us in the valley of the shadow of death. So we read from Psalm 139, verses 1 to 12. Lord, you have examined me and you know me. You know everything I do. From far away, you understand all my thoughts. You see me, whether I'm working or resting. You know all my actions. Even before I speak, you already know what I will say. You are all around me on every side. You protect me with your power. Your knowledge of me is too deep. It is beyond my understanding. Where could I go to escape from you? Where could I get away from your presence? If I went up to heaven, you would be there. If I lay down in the world of the dead, you would be there. If I flew away beyond the east or lived in the farthest place in the west, you would be there to lead me. You would be there to help me. I could ask the darkness to hide me or the light around me to turn into night, but even darkness is not dark for you, and the night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light are the same to you. Amen. Our next song is from CH4, and it's a song called Hear Me, Dear Lord, in This My Time of Sorrow. Let me just share a few words with you on that theme of light and darkness. I wonder if you were ever scared of the dark, like so many children are. The dark hides so much, and often we imagine horrors lurking in the shadows. Personally, I've always been fascinated by dark. The walks home on a dark night, the hint of Christmas in October as the streetlights light up a puddle. I loved the excitement of a power cut when I was a child, not so much as an adult. Or the sparkle of colours as decorations appear in windows and outdoors. Looking back, I realise now it wasn't the dark I loved so much, but the way that light sparkled in it. the candles that brought a warm glow and intimacy to a family huddled around, wondering when the power was going to come back on. Or the stars that shine so bright in a black sky, speaking of an immensity I can barely comprehend. The moon following me home as we drove back through rural countryside of the West Highlands. The streetlights that spoke of homes and towns, or counting Christmas trees and windows as we drove by. Grief is a dark time. Indeed, living through the pandemic has been a dark time. And we have gathered here in grief for loved ones through these past months and indeed over the years, recognizing that the grief we carry is a form of darkness. Sorrow, trauma, guilt, regret, anger, loss, all threaten to overwhelm us. The feeling of unfairness that hangs in the air like a cloud over the sun at the height of the day. Yet even in our darkest moments, there have been shafts of light. Maybe they have felt as faint as the distant stars, yet somehow still beautiful and reassuring that this isn't all there is, that we are part of something greater. Perhaps it has been the light and the warmth as you've huddled around that candle flame as a family, whether on person, in person, or on the phone, or over a screen. Perhaps it's been that sparkle of hope that brings colour to our lives, the laugh of grandchildren reminding us that life goes on, the sharing of those silly stories and remembering those special moments, and for a moment we're uplifted and buoyed again. There is no right way to travel through the darkness, and some days may well feel darker than others. But my encouragement to you is always look for the light, because the light is always there. The darkness cannot put it out. It might be small, it might be far away, but light will be there. Light that can help us process the shadows of anger, regret, guilt, fear, sorrow, and allow joy, hope, peace, and perhaps for some, healing to occur. Light therapy itself is indeed a thing. And that wonderful verse from John's Gospel reminds us that Jesus is the light of the world and the darkness will never overcome it. We can be angry with God. We can rant at him and wonder where he is. But I can assure you that even that will not put out his light. He will never, ever switch off his light for you. He will never leave you nor abandon you. And when we look for his light in all that has happened, we know he's been there. Through the people who stood by us any way they could, in prayer, in solidarity, even on the street. God is with you, and his light can help dispel the darkness, even if it takes you a long time to reach perhaps the brightness of a summer's day. And no matter how dark our world may become to us, the Lord still sees you. He still sees you, even if the day became as dark as the night. He still sees you. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. You might feel incredibly alone at this time, but please, please know that God is right there with you. And remember, even Jesus wept at the graveside of his friend and over his people who he loved, but they could not see him as he is. It is not a sin to mourn. It is not a sin to cry. It is not a sin to grieve our lost loved ones. Jesus himself said, blessed are they who mourn, for they shall be comforted. It is perhaps a daily challenge, maybe more for some, to keep looking for the light, but the light is there. My hope today is that you are comforted, and the light that even brought you to gather, whether on screen or in person or both, will be a source of strength and hope, especially in this upcoming season of Christmas and family and all that that brings with it. We share together in a beautiful song that you may have come across before. It takes us through the day and through the night. I watch the sunrise, knowing that God is with us all the time.
Sky.
Let me share with you the names that I have, knowing that perhaps the name you listen for might not be here, but know that God knows the names you carry on your heart.
Dorothea Mann, Janet Grant, Jean Hollywood, Elizabeth Flanagan, Sarah Reid, Fred McCulloch, Dougie McFarlane, Cissie McSherry, Faye Tierney, Patricia Shields, Jan Martin, Bill Lyttle, William McKay, Mann McLaughlin, William McDougall, William Swindell, Shona Smith, Margaret Prentice, Peter Kyle, Anne Booth, Tom Cunningham, Tommy Duffy, Betty Noble, Douglas Wright, John Kelly, Betty Clinton, Robert Gillespie, Les Mitchell, Mae McCann, Alan McCulloch, Tom Ruckel Sr., Mimi Ferguson, Agnes Sanders,
If I should die and leave you here a while, be not like others sore undone, who keep long vigil by the silent dust. For my sake, turn again to life and smile, nerving thy heart and trembling hand to do something to comfort other hearts than thine. Complete these dear unfinished tasks of mine, and I perchance may therein comfort you. A poem called Turn Again to Life by Mary Lee Hall. Let us come before God in prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God, before your face the generations rise and pass away. We praise your name for all your people who departed this life in your faith and love, for those dear to us, and especially those we name in our hearts now. We thank you for your loving kindness towards them, for all they were throughout their earthly lives, and for all they accomplished by your grace. We thank you that for them there is no more suffering, that death itself is past, and that they live forever in your love and care. Encourage us by the example of your saints, that we may run with resolution the race that lies ahead of us, our eyes fixed on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith, till we shall come at last with all whose we have loved to the joy and peace of your eternal presence. Bless us now, we pray, in your love, and in your name we pray. Amen. There is a song in our hymn book, and we're not going to sing it, but I want to read it to you because I want you to go with hope in your hearts, because although we grieve, the world still turns and life still is, and there is much that we have left yet to do. There is always promise of life to be. And this is called In the Bulb There Is a Flower by Natalie Sleaf. In the bulb there is a flower, in the seed an apple tree, in cocoons a hidden promise. Butterflies will soon be free. In the cold and snow of winter, there's a spring that waits to be, unrevealed until its season, something God alone can see. There's a song in every silence, seeking word and melody. There's a dawn in every darkness, bringing hope to you and me. From the past will come the future, what it holds a mystery. Unrevealed until its season, something God alone can see. In our end is our beginning, in our time infinity, in our doubt there is believing, in our life eternity, in our death a resurrection, at the last a victory. Unrevealed until its season, something God alone can see. So with these words of hope in our hearts, we take time to pray for others, indeed for tomorrow. Let us pray. God of comfort, we recognize that we are not alone, and though our grief is unique to us, we see companions all around us. And so for a moment, we hold one another in prayer as we are held in prayer by them. May we be compassionate and gracious with others, and in return receive grace and compassion as gifts of love and support. We thank you for the many people who have helped us, those who have listened with patience, who have held us in our mourning and helped us laugh again. We pray for those who guided us through the strange landscapes of funerals under restrictions, remembering our professionals who carried much without letting us know. We pray for our NHS and medical service staff who carried our pain with theirs as their hearts broke for us and with us. We pray that as we slowly heal and face the future yet unwritten, that we will be able to forgive and release all that threatens to destroy. We pray for healing in our world. We pray that peace would envelop us all, that we might live together as we ought. May we see one another as human beings, just trying to live a full life, as we head into the season of peace and goodwill to all, may there truly be peace in our time. Risen, reigning Christ, in you past, present and future are brought together in one great hope. Renew our faith in you so that neither the past may hinder us, the present overwhelm us, nor the future frighten us. You have brought us this far. Continue to lead us until our hope is fulfilled, and we join all God's people in never-ending praise. For your name's sake we pray. Amen. Please let me say thank you to Ian, our piper, and for allowing me to share his music with you here as well, and to all who made this service happen. Our closing song encourages us to remember that the Lord is all around us. May you know his presence at all times, whether in the sorrow of the night or the joy of the morning. Our closing hymn is "Be Still for the Presence of the Lord." Henry Van Dyke wrote, "Time is too slow for those who wait, too swift for those who fear, too long for those who grieve, too short for those who rejoice. But though for those who love, time is eternity." Paul writes, "There is nothing in life or death that can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus." God loves you. May you know his deep peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you, now and forevermore. Amen.